return back to the house. In, you know, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala condemns those who say, إِنَّمَا الْبَيْعُ مِثْلُ الرِّبَى. That bay' is like riba. It's the same thing. Trade is just like riba. The way that a conventional mortgage works, in essence, is that you will go to a bank, you will secure a loan, you will take that loan to buy a house, and you place your house as collateral. You place your house as collateral against that loan. If you default on your payments, the bank will repossess your house and take it away from you. There's absolutely no exchange there, except for money. You took a loan, you use that loan, your house is collateral, everything is will be taken away, auctioned off, whatever it is, foreclosed, if you're not able to pay that loan. As far as an Islamic financial system, there has to be an exchange of commodity, bay'. The company would have to fully purchase the home, assume all of its liabilities, and then sell it to you. And Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم said, لَا بَيْعَتَيْنَ فِي بَيْعَةٍ, that there is no two sales in one sale. Meaning a person cannot say, look, if you give me this amount of money, I'll go purchase this house and then sell it to you. Essentially using the money you gave to me at a higher price. Okay? Before any exchange of money takes place, they have to purchase the house and sell it to you. So that's the first thing that we see, which is obviously problematic sometimes. The second thing is assuming liabilities. In musharaka or murabaha, in a true sharia compliant system, they have to assume the liabilities of that house. They have to assume the loss of that house. So if the house takes a profit decrease, if the market value of the house goes down, then the company that's selling you the house or the person that's selling you the house should feel the effect of that just as much as you do when you're making your payments. So let's say you purchase a house for $300,000, you're making payments on that house, and then you know you're making payments to a company that purchased that house, and then later on whenever you come to sell the house, you sell it for $280,000. You don't owe the company $300,000, you should only owe them $280,000 at that point, because as co-owners of the house, they assume liability at the same time. So this is one of obviously the key flaws that we see in the system today. As for, and by the way, so we go to extremes sometimes also. If the word interest is on your, because what is halal in Islam is iqtisad. Iqtisad, which is installments. So aside from the whole profit and loss thing and those types of things, iqtisad, if I tell you I will sell you this Kleenex box for $10 now, or I will sell it to you over 6 months for $20. That is halal. That is allowed in accordance with all four madhahib. To sell something at a higher... I have 5 minutes, I'm in a rush. To sell something at a higher price is halal because there's exchange of goods here. You're not going to increase. You don't say, I'll sell it to you for $10 or $20 over 6 months, but if you can't pay in 6 months, then I'm gonna charge you a 9% interest rate and a late fee, and mark it up, and mark it up, and mark it up. No, but you can set a price from the very start. So a company can come and buy a house for $300,000 and tell you, I will sell it to you at the same rate of a conventional mortgage of 3.3% or whatever it is, so it will end up being $320,000 over 15 years. No strings attached. I own the house, so I'll sell it to you. We compute that. That comes out to $320,000 or whatever it is, I'll sell it to you for $320,000. That's fine. That's halal. That's iqtisad. Even if it says in the contract the word interest, that's fine. Okay, so we have to be fair with the Islam. We always jump on the Islam. I also have my issues, very severe disagreements with the Islamic companies. That's not one of the objections. The word interest is not one of the objections. The problem though is whenever they give you two contracts, fill out this contract for the conventional mortgage and then fill this one out, say, you know, basically which just redefines the equation, but it's the exact same thing. That's a serious issue. So you fill out the conventional mortgage, your company will actually belong to Freddie Mac. But here, you can fill this one out too, to make yourself feel better. That's like Bani Israel putting out their fishnets on Saturday, on Yom HaSabt, on the Sabbath. It's the same thing. We'll just redefine the equation so that we can Islamicize it. That is not permissible. There has to be exchange. They have to buy the house, assume the assets, liabilities, and sell it to you. Okay? Unfortunately, I think sometimes we don't put our companies to the proper, whenever you want to buy something, you need to check its Sharia compliance.